In Lincoln, a child is hit by a car, and when his family confronts the alleged driver, a shootout ends with the child's father dead. Good evening, everyone. I'm Melissa Fry.
And I'm Adrian Witset. Lincoln police say there was a shootout near 30th and W around 11:30 Wednesday night, and 41-year-old Orlando Cifuentes was shot in the chest and killed. KTV News Watch 7's Andrew Ozaki shows us how it all unfolded.
Investigators pore over the lawn where a deadly gun battle played out amidst the sounds of fireworks Wednesday night. Neighbors who don't want to be identified tell me this black SUV pulled up to this North Lincoln duplex around 11:30. They say two people came out with guns drawn, yelling at the person living inside the residence. They say 23-year-old Robert Robertson came out with an assault rifle. When he raised it, they say this man, 18-year-old Matthew Guerrera, started shooting. Robinson fired back.
He returned some fire, shooting back at the people out in the street.
Police believe Robinson fired 8 to 10 rounds, one fatally hitting 41-year-old Orlando Cifuentes in the chest, another round hitting Guerrera in the calf.
He felt that he was being threatened.
So far, police have not found any other weapons except for Robinson's. They did locate 5 bullet holes in Robinson's home.
We're probably lucky that we don't have more people hurt as a result of this.
Police believe the showdown was a result of frustration that had built up over a hit-and-run accident that happened an hour and a half before the shooting. Cifuentes' 8-year-old son was lighting fireworks a block away when a red car hit him in the side view mirror and sped off. The boy was taken to a hospital and treated for minor injuries. The family tracked the car to Robinson's home, but police say they didn't have enough evidence at the time to arrest Robinson.
The officer had checked the vehicle, did not observe any damage to the vehicle at that particular point in time.
Police have since arrested Robinson for leaving the scene of an injury accident, a felony, but want to conduct more interviews to determine if additional charges will be filed or if the shootings were in self-defense. They say, sadly, Robinson would probably have been arrested for the hit and run all along.
These are some of the tragedies that can wind up happening as a result of that, where you get emotions that start running high. And you don't let the police wind up doing their job and conducting an investigation.
Or if the shootings were in self-defense.
Andrew Ozaki reporting. Now, a check of Robinson's driving record shows he has had a number of violations, including driving under the influence and driving on a suspended license.